Hi everyone, in this video we will learn about data classes. Data classes is another cool feature of Kotlin that can be used when we need to create a class just for storing data. In this video I will take example of Java. So these kind of classes that we create in Java just for storing data are called Pojo classes, that is plain old Java object. And for the sake of example, I have already created a Pojo class in Java. So this class is called person and I have to store three values for this person, that are ID, name and country. And just for storing these three values, I have to create a constructor and getters for all these three values. And sometimes I also need to override the toString function, the equals function and the hashcode function. So just for these three simple variables, I have created a class for more than 51 lines. And these all are just boilerplate code that I need to write for every Pojo class. So these codes are useless. And every time I add a new variable in my Pojo class, I need to generate all these codes again, because IDE can generate all these boilerplate codes, but still it is not a good idea to have this much amount of code inside a simple class. And Kotlin fixed this problem using the data classes. So let's create the same class person in Kotlin. So what I will do is I will create a data class this time. And to create a data class, you need to use the data keyword and then the class keyword and then your class name. So I will create a class name person. And here we need to have three values. So we will define three values as val ID string, val name string and val country. It is also a string and that's it. This class is equivalent to this class. So in Java you have to write 50 lines, but in Kotlin it is basically just one line. I can put it in one line because we just have the class and the constructor. So this is Kotlin and this is Java. I cannot create two classes with the same name and that is why I am getting an error here. So just for now I will comment all the code inside this person.java. So we have a data class person, and when you are creating a data class, you cannot make it open or abstract. So when you are using a data keyword, you cannot use open, abstract or inner keywords with data classes. And in data class, you cannot have a blank constructor. So if I try to create the constructor blank, I will get an error. You can see we are getting an error. So you have to provide at least one value inside the constructor. You can have class body and you can override the equals hashcode and toString function if required, but in most of the cases it is not needed because the basic thing is already done with data class. So if I create an instance of this data class, let's say we have a person. So we have a person, and if I write println person, I will get all the values because the toString function is already created and you do not need to override it. As you can see, we are getting all the values in a string format. So this was the toString function, and you can also compare two persons. Let's say person one, and let's say this time I will change the name to anyone else. Let's say some name. And if I will print person equals to person one, I will get false. You can see we have false. But if I will put the name Bilal, then I will get true because the equals function is also created by default. You can see we are getting true. You can override the equals function and the toString function if required, but it's not needed because the basic thing is already done. Now, one more thing with data class is you can have body of your data class if required. For example, you have, let's say, val fname and lname. Then if required, you can create a function like this, and this function can return fname and lname like this. So you can simply print person.getName. So you can have the body for your data class if required. And this time we need to pass first name and last name. So let's pass it. And let's run the code. So you can see we are getting true and the full name. And one more thing with data class is you can inherit another class to your data class. You can implement interface, you can inherit another class, but you cannot inherit another data class to your data class, because as I said, you cannot use open keyword or abstract keyword with data keyword. So these classes are final and you cannot extend these data classes. So this was one thing. And another function that Kotlin generates for you is the componentN function with all your data class. So this is another useful feature. I will tell you how. First, let's understand what is componentN function. So with this instance, that is the person instance, what I can do is I can print person.component1. So it will generate the componentN function for all your properties. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4. So it will generate component 1, component 2, component 3, and component 4. And that's why it is called componentN function, where N is the number of properties. So it will start from 1 and go till the number N. And 1 means ID, 2 means fname, 3 means last name, and 4 means country. Let's see if it is working. You can see we are getting all the values. Now why it is useful? So with the help of componentN function, you can destructure the declaration. And what it means is you can simply get all these values in vals. So you can assign all these values inside a val directly in a single line. And you can do it like this. You will create val ID, fname, lname, and country, and equals to, let's say, person. So this is called destructuring declaration. And now you can print, let's say, println ID. I will comment out these things because it will print them again. So let's see if it is working. So you can see we are getting all the values. So this is how you can create data classes, and it is way better than Java, requires less line of codes, and it have all the basic things by default. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something. In case you have any problem or question, you can leave your comments below. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Bilal Khan, now signing off.